following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
I'm glad you showed up because all Tony Saletan, my man! You put something in my hand. How you been?
Okay, how you?
What you been doing?
Well, just doing some school concerts in town. I thought I'd drop by for a minute.
That's a guess that you're here. Wait a minute. Hey, Susan! Susan, come
hey,
on, look who's here!
Tony,
jump back. Hey, Mr. Hooper!
Yes.
Look who's here! Tony! Hey, Big Bird! Big Bird! Big Bird. Come on down! Well, Tony's here!
Big Bird!
Yeah, what's the last time we saw him?
Tony,
you know, every time I drop around Sesame Street, there seem to be all these numbers and letters floating around, so I brought some new songs about them. Want to hear them? Well, here's a letter song. I think if you listen to it the first time, you'll be able to catch on by the second time. It's really a song that sailors used to sing about. A is for anchor, and sometimes lumbermen used to sing A is for axe. And here's a version for you. A is for apple, and that you all know. B is for boy, and for Big Bird also.
For me.
C is for cat that goes meow or meow. D is for dog that goes woof or bow wow. So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No people on earth as happy as we, so clap with your hands and then stamp with your feet, and that's how we'll do it on Sesame Street. Right, you might as well try that. It's just clap with your hands and then stamp with your feet, and that's how we'll do it on Sesame Street. You got it. Next time you can sing so merry, and so on. You'll catch on. E is so easy for egg and for elephant. F, I forgot. G is for grandmother Gordon and grouse. H is for Hooper and hot dog and house. So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No people on earth as happy as we. So clap with your hands and stand with your feet. And that's how we'll do it on Sesame Street. Right, I is for ice cream that's tasty and cold. J is for Jack and Jill's story I'm told. K is for kiss, and it's also for kite. L is for love, and for learn, and for light. So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No people on earth are happy as we. So clap with your hands, and stamp with your feet. And that's how we'll do it on Sesame Street. Well, M is for mailman that brings us the mail. N is for nothing, and it's also for nail. O is for Oscar, who lives in the can.
Oh, yeah.
E is for people and pickle and pan.
So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No people on earth as happy as we. So clap with your hands and stand with your feet. And that's how we do it on Sesame Street.
Well, Q is for quack. Take the word of a duck. R is for rolling along like a truck. S is for sandwich and Susan and so. T is for Tony and tickle your toe. So merry, so merry, so merry are we. No people on earth as happy as we.
So clap with your hands and stand with your feet. And that's how we'll do it on Sesame Street.
Well, here's a long one. U for umbrella we use in the rain. V looks like this and it's also for vain. W for window that you can look through. And X is for x-ray and xylophone too. And Y is for yellow, a color so bright. Z for a zipper that zips us up tight. So merry,
so merry, so merry are we. No people on earth as happy as we.
So
clap with your hands and stamp with your feet. And that's how we'll do it on Sesame Street.
Once more,
clap with your hands.
Hey, Greg, you know what that is? That he's got?
An instrument!
That was great! What kind?
A piano.
Not really big, bird.
Not a piano.
Who knows what it is?
Me!
Come on.
A banjo!
A banjo, she's right. Were you going to say banjo?
Banjo. What was this one that he just finished playing?
Guitar.
That's right.
Right. Well, here's the banjo.
That's an easy one, but that's a hard one.
Well, now you know it's a banjo.
Banjo.
I'll play a banjo song about counting, and I think if you just listen to it the first time, you'll catch right on. It goes like this. There was one, there were two, there were three little angels. There were four, there were five, there were six little angels. There were seven, there were eight, there were nine little angels. 10 little angels in the band. Oh, wasn't that a band? Sunday morning, Sunday morning, Sunday morning, wasn't that a band? Sunday morning, Sunday morning, so soon. I think you can do that. Just there were one, there were two. You got it? Try it.
There were one, there were two, there were three little angels. There were four, there were five, there were six little angels. There were seven, there were eight, there were nine little angels. 10 little angels in the band.
Oh, wasn't that a band? Sunday morning,
Sunday morning, Sunday morning, Sunday morning.
Yes, wasn't that a band? Hey, pretty good. Since it's so easy for your forward, how about trying it backward? We get a little tricky. There were 10, there were 9, there were 8, right? Here we go.
There were 10, there were 9, there were 8 little angels. There were 7, there were 6, there were 5 little angels.
You know it better.
There were 4, there were 3, there were 2 little angels. One little angel in the band.
Oh!
Hey, you know what counting backwards is good for?
No.
For going up, up, and away.
Now, brought to you by the makers of the alphabet, the one and only one of its kind, the letter Z. Just look at the beautiful pattern of Z. You'll want to use your Z in the word freeze and zero. There's no limit to the words you can make with the letter Z. For example, zoo. And living in the zoo, zebra, and lizard. And if that weren't enough, Z is also fun to say. Say it with me. Z. It tickles the tip of your tongue. And now, my young letter collectors, when it comes to a groovy letter in the alphabet, you can't beat the letter Z. Try it today.
Oh, Mr. Hooper, you too. Let's right. give him a big yeah. hand. Let's give him a hand.
Thank you.
That's terrific.
Hey, come on, everybody. Why doesn't everybody come in and have milk and cookies and pie and coffee
oh,
and stuff?
Oh, amateurs and fried chicken, potato salad, mustard greens. Yeah, come on. Let's, everybody in.
Everybody. Say, while Susan and Gordon are cutting up the pie and pouring the milk, I've got a song that you can help me make up. How's that? It's a wishing song. And it's about animals. And all you have to do is think of an animal that you might like to be and a place where that animal would be. I'll give you an example. I wish I was a mole in the ground. I wish I was a mole in the ground. If I was a mole in the ground, I'd root that mountain down. I wish I was a mole in the ground. Now suppose you don't want to be a mole in the ground. Maybe you want to be something else. I wish I was a lizard in the spring. I wish I was a lizard in the spring. If I was a lizard in the spring, I'd hear my darling sing. I wish I was a lizard in the spring. You get the idea? Who's got an idea for an animal and a place where that animal might be? George.
A gorilla.
Where should we have the gorilla?
In a park.
In a park? Okay. Let's see. You can sing that too. I wish I was a gorilla in the park. Let me sing it again.
I wish I was a gorilla in the park.
Now let's see. If I was a gorilla in the park, I'd just live there all through the dark. Another idea for an animal and a place where that animal might be. Let's. Oh, I'm looking for somebody just holding up a hand quietly. Let's try Gillian.
A snail.
A snail. Where shall we have a snail?
In the ground.
And a snail on the ground. I wish I was a snail on the ground. You can sing that too.
I wish I was a snail on the ground.
If I was a snail on the ground, well, my shell would go round and round.
Snail on the ground.
Another idea. How about Gregory?
Tiger.
A tiger. Okay, where should we have the tiger?
In the park.
Well, we had a park already.
Zoo.
How about a zoo? Okay, that starts with a Z, right, Mr.
Yes.
Hooper? I wish I was a tiger in the zoo.
I wish I was a tiger in the zoo.
If I was a tiger in the zoo, I might cry. Another idea for an animal and a place. Ava.
Well, I guess I could say a fish.
A fish. Where should we have the fish?
Well, in a water pond.
In the pond. I wish I was a fish in the pond.
I wish I was a fish in the pond.
If I was a fish in the pond, what rhymes with pond? Let's see.
Oh,
my gills I would have donned. I wish I was a fish in the pond. Another idea. Christopher.
A snake in the grass.
A snake in the grass.
Christopher, I wish I could show you this. You know what it is?
What is that?
No. It's a limberjack.
What's that?
What is a limberjack? You want to find out?
Yeah. A man who cuts down trees?
No, that's a lumberjack. That was close, though. That was very good.
That's why they call this a lumberjack.
Tell you what you do. You just sit it on here, on a stool, right? Then you sit on the board, like that.
Yep.
Got it? So far. Then you take the limberjack and you stand him over here and Tony gives me some music.
Okay.
We can make a dance.
Let's try it.
Thank you.
Black guy lumberjack.
Oh, watch here out, comes sweetheart. Susan. Watch out.
I hope you like apple pie. Boy, this pie has quite a story behind it.
Pass it around and help
me. Pass it around.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Now, no. Tony Saletan is going to get his guitar together, and he's going to give us a couple of more swinging tunes.
Hey, here's a song that Woody Guthrie wrote that you can help me do. All you have to do is get a hand, choose one hand, and find your thumb. Got a thumb
get
up?
Get your thumb up.
And what you do is this. I drop my thumb, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my thumb, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my thumb, pick it up, and put it back with my fingers. How about I drop my dolly, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my dolly, pick her up gently. I drop my dolly, pick her up, and lay her back in her cradle. I drop my shoe, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my shoe, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my shoe, pick it up, and put it back with my other shoe. I drop my head, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my head, pick it up, pick it up. I drop my head, pick it up, and put it back on my shoulders. Try singing. Pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Pick, 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 pick it up. Once more, it's pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Pick, 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 pick it up, pick it up. Hey,
very good. Very good. Bravo.
How about a song in Spanish? I got a song called Mi Chacra, which is all about a farm and different animals. And see if you can tell what the animals are. For instance, I'll begin with El Perrito. Anybody have an idea what El Perrito might be? Listen and you'll find out. Vengan a ver mi chacra, que es hermosa. Vengan a ver mi chacra, que es hermosa. El Perrito hace así. El perrito hace así. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, pas. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, pas. Right, you might as well sing. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, pas. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, pas. And that just means, oh, step. So if you feel like stepping, use your feet. Here's another animal. El burrito. See what el burrito is. And I'll sing it in English so everybody will know what's going on. Oh, come and see my farm, which is so pretty. Come and see my farm, which is so beautiful. El burrito goes like this. Yeah, yeah.
A donkey.
El burrito goes like this. Yeah. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Here's el patito. Vengan a ver mi chacra, que es hermosa. Vengan a ver mi chacra, que es hermosa. We'll find out. El patito hace así. Quack, quack. El patito hace así. Quack, quack. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. How about el caballo? Come and see my farm, which is so beautiful. Come and see my farm, which is so beautiful. I think you got it. El caballo goes like this. El caballo goes like this. Hey, hey, you got it, George. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. Oh, pas camarado, paso, paso, paso. We'll do one more, and it'll be el gatito.
Okay.
See my farm, which is so beautiful. Vengan a ver mi chacra, que es hermosa. El gatito hace así.
Meow cat.
You're way ahead of me. El gatito hace así.
Meow.
Meow.
Oh, you can use your feet. Oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, oh, pas, oh, pas. Oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, oh, pas, oh, pas. Oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, oh, pas, oh, pas. Oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, camarada, oh, pas, oh, pas, oh, pas.
Hey! Olé!
Olé!
Hey!
Hey!
I'm
here,
Gatito! Hey, Tony, how are you?
Nice to see you. I haven't seen you all day.
Hey, that's a nice song.
Thank you, Bob. And here's a gatito.
And here's a gatito, right? Yeah,
a gatito.
A real Persian gatito.
A Persian gatito.
You don't see many Persian
gatitos. Where have you been all day?
Oh, I was down at school cutting up some wood and making a...
You're always cutting up.
I'm always cutting up, right? Nice. Isn't this a nice one?
Yeah.
This is a Persian cat.
I like him.
Do you?
Yeah.
You can tell he's Persian because he has nice, long fur hair. Some cats are nice short hair, but this is long, huh? Like that?
Yeah.
He's got whiskers.
Pretty one.
What if he has 9 lives?
Yeah.
Cats have 9 lives, right?
Yeah.
Any of you have cats?
Yes.
Yeah?
We're taking care of one. That's all.
You're taking care of one. Yeah. I hope you take good care of it.
Oh, got
give them things to eat. Hey, by the way, Tony, mm-hmm. could you count the cat's paws in Spanish?
Oh, let's
Uno.
See.
See how many he's got here.
Uno. George can help too.
Uno.
Dos. Tres.
Cuatro.
That's 4.
That's 4.
In English, that's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Did you like that kitten? He was pretty, wasn't he? The kids and Bob all went to the pet shop to take it back. Such a lovely kitten. While I'm sitting here, I thought maybe I'd read you a story. Would you like that? Come a little closer and sit down. I'm going to read the story called Ask Mr. Bear. Let's see what we ask him here. Once there was a boy named Danny. And one day, Danny's mother had a birthday. Danny said to himself, what shall I give my mother for a birthday? So Danny started out to see what he could find. He walked along and he met a hen. Good morning, Mrs. Hen, said Danny. Can you give me something for my mother's birthday? Cluck, cluck, said the hen. I can give you a nice fresh egg for your mother's birthday. Thank you, said Danny, but she has an egg. Let's see what we can find then, said the hen. So Danny and the hen skipped along until they met a goose. Good morning, Mrs. Goose, said Danny. Can you give me something for my mother's birthday? Honk, honk, said the goose. I can give you some nice feathers to make a fine pillow for your mother's birthday. Thank you, said Danny, but she has a pillow. Let's see what we can find then, said the goose. So Danny and the hen and the goose all hopped along until they met a goat. Good morning, Mrs. Goat, said Danny. Can you give me something for my mother's birthday? Meh, meh, said the goat. I can give you some milk for making cheese. Thank you, said Danny, but she has some cheese. Let's see what we can find then, said the goat. So Danny and the hen and the goose and the goat all galloped along until they met a sheep. Good morning, Mrs. Sheep, said Danny. Can you give me something for my mother's birthday? Baa, baa, said the sheep. I can give you some wool to make a warm blanket for your mother's birthday. Thank you, said Danny, but gee, she has a blanket. Let's see if what we can find then, said the sheep. So Danny and the hen and the goose and the goat and the sheep all trotted along until they met a cow. Good morning, Mrs. Cow, said Danny. Can you give me something for my mother's birthday? Moo, moo, said the cow. I can give you some milk and cream. Thank you, said Danny, but she has some milk and cream. Then ask Mr. Bear, said the cow. He lives in the woods over the hill. All right, said Danny. Let's go and ask Mr. Bear. No, said the hen. No, said the goose. No, said the goat. No, said the sheep. No, said the cow. So Danny went alone to find Mr. Bear. He ran until he came to the hill. And he walked and he walked until he came to the woods. And then he met Mr. Bear. Good morning, Mr. Bear, said Danny. Can you give me something for my mother's birthday? Hmm, said the bear. I have nothing to give you for your mother's birthday, but I can tell you something you can give her. So Mr. Bear whispered a secret in Danny's ear. Oh, said Danny. Thank you, Mr. Bear. Then he ran through the woods, and he skipped down the hill, and he came to his house. Guess what I have for your birthday, Danny said to his mother. So his mother tried to guess. She said, is it an egg? No, it isn't an egg, said Danny. Is it a pillow? No, it isn't a pillow, said Danny. Is it cheese? Nope, it isn't cheese, said Danny. Is it a blanket? No, it isn't a blanket, said Danny. Is it milk or cream? No, it isn't milk or cream, said Danny. His mother could not guess. So Danny gave his mother a big birthday bear hug. That was the secret that Mr. Bear told Danny. And those are the best kind, a great big warm hug. And that's the best present that any of you can ever give your mother.
G, 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 G.
Hey, Big Bird. Mm. Do you mind telling me why you're walking around here saying G, G?
Well, because, wait a minute. You made me forget what I was saying.
You were saying G, G, G. You were walking up here saying G.
What was it I was saying, though?
G, G. You were saying G.
Well, that doesn't help at all.
Why were you trying to say G?
I forgot what I was saying. If I can remember, wait a minute. Right here. I wrote down on this piece of paper. Here, read it.
Oh, okay, wait a minute.
If, on that piece of paper, I have written very carefully what I was saying, so I wouldn't forget.
That's a letter G, Big Bird. It's a G.
Oh, yes, there it is, the letter G.
All right,
That's it. I put it there to remind me.
To remind you of what? Remind you of what, Big Bird?
I forget.
Well, look, let me try to help you. You know your grandmother, Grandmother Bird?
Yes.
You remember her?
Yeah.
Were you trying to think of her? Because grandmother starts with G. Maybe you're trying to think of Grandmother Bird.
Oh, she's so nice. But that wasn't it.
That wasn't it. How about Oscar? He's a grouch.
Oh, G. Grouch. Grouch is a G word.
That's right. That's right. Were you trying to think of Oscar?
No.
Not. What about me? Gordon. Gordon. Huh? Starts with a G.
Oh, Gordon. Hi,
yeah.
Gordon.
Yeah, hi, Big
How are
Bird.
You?
Fine. But
G, you're great.
Were you trying to think of me?
No, it wasn't you, Gordon.
You weren't trying to think of me.
Wait a minute. I remember.
You got it.
Yes.
I can tell.
Yes. I was on my way to go look for Bob. And I kept saying G to remind me because I got a letter from my sister, Tondalea. See? And she said, be sure to say hello to Bob.
Your sister, Tondalea Bird, said, say hello to Bob?
She said, tell Bob hello.
Yeah, well, what does that have to do with the letter G, Big Bird?
Well, she also laid 14 eggs last month. She mentioned that in the letter.
Big Bird, what does that have to do with the letter G?
Well, this month, the eggs hatched.
Big Bird, I still don't... What does that have to do with the letter G?
Well, listen, 14 eggs. I thought to myself, whoa, 14 baby birds in one little nest. G. So I've been saying it again and again to remind me to go tell Bob, hello, G, G, G.
Well, I don't understand it, but he does, and that's all that matters.
Oh, boy. Yeah, it's time for my nap. Oh, my tired. Ah. No. Hey, Bird. Oh, Bird. Oh, buddy, Bird. Hey, Bird. Bird, where are you, Bird? Oh. Gee. You know, it is just possible that my old buddy Bird here is asleep. For one thing, he's lying down, which he usually does when he is asleep. For another thing, his eyes are closed. And for another thing, he's not answering me when I talk. So old buddy Bert is probably asleep, but I will check just to make sure. Poke, 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 poke. Note how I can poke old buddy Bert in the stomach and he doesn't complain. Now, when old Buddy Bert is awake and I poke him in the stomach, he complains. Oh, looky here. Note how floppy and soggy-like old Buddy Bert's arm is. Yeah, when old Buddy Bert is awake, he's not floppy and soggy-like. So, I am quite certain that old Buddy Bert is very definitely asleep. On the other hand, now his eyes are open. My old Buddy Bert's eyes are usually open only when he is awake, so he's probably awake, but I will check just to make sure. Poke, 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 poke.
Now cut that out.
See, I was right. He's awake.
Ernie.
Yeah?
Why did you wake me up?
Did I wake you up, old buddy?
Yes, you did.
See, I was right. First he was asleep, now he is awake.
Ernie, why'd you wake me up?
Let's see, because I have something very important to tell you.
What's that?
Well, you see, I just looked at the clock.
So?
It's time for your nap. Oh, sleep tight.
Hey, we have just enough time for one more song from Tony Saletan. Is everybody ready for it?
Yeah!
Okay, go, Tony.
Well, it's been so much fun working with you all together today. I'll sing a song about all working together. Woody Guthrie said, we all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. And we can sing that together, and you can sing it with us, too. We all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. Try it. Oh, we all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. Another part says, with a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle, a jigger and a jagger and a giggle and a grin. Try that if you like. Let's do the whole thing. Oh, we all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. We all work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle, a jigger and a jagger and a giggle and a grin. There's a part you can act out, too. My mama told me, teacher told me, too. There's all kinds of work for me to do. You can really try to get up and do this. I can dry my dishes and I can sweep my floor. But if we all work together, well, it won't take long. So we all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. All work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle, a jigger and a jacker and a giggle and a grin. My sister told me, brother told me too. There's lots and lots of work that I can do. I can bring her candy and I can bring him gum. Check, he gets a lot of gum. But we all work together, well, it won't take long. So we all work together with a wiggle and a giggle. All work together with a giggle and a grin. With a wiggle and a giggle and a google and a woogle, a jigger and a jigger and a giggle and a grin. My daddy told me, grandpa told me too. There's a work, for me to do. I can paint my fence, there you go. And I can mow this lawn. But if we all work together, well, it won't take long. So we all work together with a wiggle.
Hey, we've been swinging and singing and working together here on Sesame Street. We've had a great time. Really want to thank Tony Saletan for joining us. And you come back and join us as soon as you can, okay? Goodbye.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G, O, and Z, and by the number 4. Ask Mr. Bear, story and pictures by Marjorie Flack, published by Macmillan Company, copyright 1932. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.